Hi. If you are part of an organization, regardless of your role, and if you're interested in managing your own personal performance, there are two main ways where you can do that. Number one, the most obvious way is measure your performance against the targets that you have been given, against the objectives that you have been given, against the expectations of your, you know, management, of your bosses, because you're part of the organization to fulfill a role. And in principle, whomever employed you has a set of expectations, targets, objectives, whatever that is. And they should be also clear to you. So you always, you know, you have this criteria of measuring yourself in terms of performance against these targets. If you did well, then that's brilliant. And in my mind, if you achieve your targets, that's the least that you can do. Why do I say the least? Because if you fail on them or even in some of them, what do you think will be the reaction? The reaction will be that you did not meet all your targets. So you're already in a defensive position. So why be there? So why put yourself there? Provided, of course, the targets are realistic and it has been, you know, originally to begin with agreed with you, you know, at an earlier stage that this is the expectation and you said, fine, I can deliver that. You see? If they are not realistic, then what are we talking about? And then you can't even measure this because you're measuring something that's realistic to something that's not realistic. So I'm assuming that's all realistic and it has been done with agreement with you. So that's the first kind of measurement. You measure yourself against the targets and the objectives given to you by your superiors, and you make sure that you achieve all of them, all of them. Because, okay, let's see, 95% achieved. The 95%, you know, we will be discussed when your bosses and you talk about your performance, even if you are the CEO, and, you know, the same applies to you because you have a board of directors and you have shareholders. So nobody is exempted from this. The president of a country also goes through this. How? Through the re-election process and through what the media is talking about them and what opposition is saying. So people watch your performance all the time. So what happens is that you make sure that all of your objectives or targets are achieved, you know, to your best of your abilities, so that you don't end up sort of, you know, the 5% that were missed become the focus of attention, because that will happen. If you have people who are envious, jealous, you know, adversaries, resistance, opposition, whatever that is, they will emphasize all the spotlight on the 5% that you haven't achieved. And let's say that doesn't exist. You and your boss, when you sit together and talk about your performance, or bosses, let's say if you have a board of director, then they will say thank you very much for the first 95%, but the remaining 5% will also be mentioned. So don't be there if you can. Now, what is best is that you exceed your performance. Always make sure that you exceed whatever has been expected from you, because you want to create, you know, a lasting impression. You want to score in your favor. You don't want them to say, well done, thank you, all objectives achieved. No, you want them to say, you know, overperformed. Aim for that. Why? Because it puts you on the offensive. They owe you more than you owe them, whoever your bosses are, because you overachieved, right? And you can use that overachievement to improve your position, whether it is like my salary increase, better working conditions, promotions, more respect, more appreciation, more distinction. There's so many ways that you can translate this exceptional behavior. So many ways. Flexibility in the way they deal with you. You will build yourself a capital, you know, of sort of reputation and brand, so that if something went wrong in the future, at least, you know, you have a capital that you can use, because it will be an exception to the rule, because your normal rule is that you always exceed expectations. You see, so do that. Tactically, it's very important that you always exceed. Now, the implication is that when you keep exceeding your expectations, their expectations from you, what will happen is that maybe next time they will build that into your next year's objectives. In this case, you can also negotiate. Don't allow this to happen. And have a frank conversation with your bosses that, you know, if we keep doing that, then you're really squeezing me. It's not healthy. Give me what's normal, you know, what's fair, like everybody else. And if I exceed, reward me. I'm going to do my best anyway. So don't put me under extra pressure just because, you know, I'm doing well. Be fair like everybody else, and I will promise, you know, that I will exceed. I will at least try my best to exceed. But just because I'm doing well, you know, you put me under more pressure than my colleagues, than what is normal. So negotiate that, and you will have a point. You see? The second point that you can use to measure your own performance is yourself. Is what standard you expect from yourself? Because what you do is an expression of you, of your professionalism, of your skills, of your attitude, of the way you regard yourself and conduct yourself as a professional, whatever your domain is, and regardless of what your, you know, bosses expect from you. Because in the end, it's your brand, your reputation. Would you accept into something mediocre? Because if you act in a mediocre or to produce mediocre outcome, you will receive mediocre behavior and treatment. So why put yourself in that position? Always measure yourself and your performance, you know, with your, not just your current capabilities, but your potential. Because your objective is to stretch yourself. You're not just doing that for the sake of, you know, professional reasons. You're doing that also for personal growth. And the more you do that, the more you'll stretch yourself. And the more you stretch yourself, the higher will be your value and worth in society and in your domain of industry and business and organization. And you can use that to translate it into better conditions, better, you know, financial conditions, better promotions, better responsibilities, a better, you know, positioning within the organization. So do that and you'll be fine. Meet the expectations of your bosses, exceed them, and more importantly, meet your own expectations. And if you do that, trust me, the speed of your promotions, of your moving forward to live the optimal life that you could live, will be determined by you. And even if you work for an organization and there are sort of roadblocks and there are processes and what, sooner or later this will be broken and there will be a way made specially for you. You would make your way. And if they couldn't, then you will have no problem at all in finding alternatives, because you are such a high value person. So who would not want you to join them? See? Do that, you'll be on the right track.